Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Thursday of the 13th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. All people, clap your hands. Cry to God with shouts of joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we begin a new month, no, the month of July, of course, having been a former Jesuit, for us, this is Ignatian month. No, so if you notice, our statues here in our prayer room is the statue of Saint Ignatius and, of course, Our Lady of Montserrat. I'll say a little bit more about Our Lady of Montserrat, not just today, but in the coming days, no, during this month. So, my dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a burnt offering on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac, and two of his servants as well, and with the wood that he had cut for the burnt offering, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go over yonder. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon, Abraham took the wood for the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," he said. "Yes, son," he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the burnt offering?" "Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the burnt offering." Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering in place of his son. Abraham named the site Yahweh Yireh. Hence, people now say, "On the mountain the Lord will see." Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from the heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies. And in your descendants, all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command. Abraham then returned to his servants, and they set out together for Beersheba, where Abraham made his home. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, because of your kindness, because of your truth. Why should the pagans say, where is their God?
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, the handiwork of men.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
They have mouths but speak not. They have eyes but see not. They have ears but hear not. They have noses but smell not.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Their makers shall be like them, everyone who trusts in them. The house of Israel trusts in the Lord. He is their help and their shield.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Alleluia, alleluia. God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came into his own town. And there were people brought to him, a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." At that, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He then said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your mat, and go home." He rose and went home, and when the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God who had given such authority to men. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, today's Gospel is, for me, one of my favorite Gospels, no? Because it talks about, So many important points to reflect on. First of all, I don't know if you noticed that in the versions of the gospel, because this appears in the other synoptic gospels, it says when Jesus saw their faith, yung pananampalataya ng mga kaibigan ng paralitiko, nung nakita ng Panginoon yung pananampalataya ng mga kaibigan, yun din yung pumukaw sa damdamin niya para patawarin at hilumin yung paralytic, no? So for me, that's always very striking, no? When Jesus saw their faith, it reminds us that, you know, we are here for each other. It reminds us that we are a community of faith, and therefore we should really, in a sense, bring each other closer to Christ, and really to each of us would need some healing. And kailangan iangat tayo ng ating community, yung pananampalataya ng ating community. Maybe that first point to reflect on, ano? That, you know, we, di ba na may kasabihan, di ba? nobody goes to heaven alone. Lahat tayo sama-samang magtutulungan umakyat sa langit, no? And that's the first point that I invite you to reflect on, no? That we are a community of faith and that we must bring each other to Christ. We must bring each other to healing and conversion, no? Then the second point that I like in this gospel is that when the Lord healed the paralytic, he says your sins are forgiven. He did not say rise up and pick up your stretcher and walk, no? Because remember, during that time, illness is always associated with sin, no? Tandaan natin na yun ang, kumbaga yan ang mindset ng mga tao ng araw. Pagka may sakit ka, meron ka kasing kasalanan. Diba? That was the mindset. That's why nauunawaan ng Panginoon din yung struggle ng paralitiko. Na may struggle siya na kaya ako nagkaganito, makasalanan ako, etc. No? So in a sense, no, the Lord understood the interior struggle of the paralytic. And again, here again, it shows you the compassion of Christ. That he understood what was in the inmost being of the paralytic, and therefore he heals his interior self. No, your sins are forgiven. And of course, nagkaroon ng reaction yan, di ba? Nagkaroon ng reaction. And then makikita mo rin, ang Panginoon basa rin niya yung mga kalaban. And this is the third point, ano? Basa rin niya yung kasamaan, no? Yung pagkamalisyoso ng mga religious authorities, no? And so the Lord turns to them and says, okay, just to I understand the malice of your thoughts, no? But just to keep you quiet, no? He tells the paralytic, okay, just to prove I can forgive sins, pick up your stretcher and walk. Now, these two incidents of basang-basa ng Diyos yung paralitiko at yung mga masasamaang isip, it shows you, no, the depth of the Lord's understanding. Na, 'di ba, for me that is very powerful, eh. Na alam mo ang Diyos natin, nauunawaan ko anong nangyayari sa kalooban natin. Yung ating struggle kagaya ng paralitiko at kahit yung ating kasamaan, yung ating malicious thoughts, no? The Lord understands even our propensity to sin, no? And for me that is such a consoling fact that we have a God, we have a Savior who understands our interior movements. Be it our struggles, be it our joys actually, or our faith, and be it our evil inclinations. And therefore, we must turn to Him and really ask Him to help us, you know, heal what has to be healed, to overcome the evil that is in us, the propensity for evil, and also to strengthen our faith. Ang ating Diyos ay nauunawaan tayo. Sabi nga ni San Agustin, di ba? Na ikaw ay mas you are more intimate to me than I am to myself. Mas nauunawaan mo yung kalooban ko kaysa sa aking sarili. So today as we begin the Ignatian journey, Ignatius who had a terrific really understanding of human nature, no? Let us pray that this coming month, you know, we may develop that deeper self-awareness of ourselves, and that's our project for this month in our reflections. And then also in discovering an awareness of self to discover God's presence and love in our lives and in our hearts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In Capernaum, among the sick who came to Jesus for healing was a paralytic brought to him on a stretcher. Jesus healed him of sickness that paralyzed his body and released him from sin that imprisoned his soul. Let us ask the Lord for healing of both body and soul. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Church make those who are suffering feel the presence of Christ, who consoles and cares for the sick, heals every hurt, and liberates from sin through His forgiveness. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May hospital administrators, chaplains, and families of the sick attend to the spiritual needs of the sick that they may trust in the Lord and experience peace. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the sick and the disabled, the lonely and the depressed, and those who bear the burden of sin, Hear the liberating words of Christ. Arise and go home. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the burden of sickness and age carried by the sick and the elderly be made lighter by the love of their family and their attendants. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May those who work in hospitals, attending to the sick, lying on stretchers, be protected from contamination, appreciated for their labors, and afforded financial security. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers for this Mass. And please remember also, as we are on the 8th day of the novena for President Noynoy, let us remember him also. For all of these intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together we pray the prayer for the 2022 elections. God our Father, as we prepare for our 2022 elections, we put our trust in your promise that you will send us leaders after your own heart and spirit. Lord Jesus, inspire all who seek office to be servant leaders who will put the greater good of the greater majority, especially the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable, above any personal or group interests. Servant leaders who will seek office to genuinely serve and not to be served. Servant leaders of integrity and compassion. Holy Spirit, enlighten our minds and hearts that we may see clearly the needs of our people and what candidates promise and their ability to fulfill these. That we choose rightly the leaders who will truly lead and serve. Leaders after your own heart and spirit. Leaders who will unite and lead us to do what is for the greater good of the greater majority and what is for your greater glory. Father, Son, and Spirit, you are the God of life and love, the Lord of history. Be with us in this time of preparation for the coming elections. Amen. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember especially all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We offer them to you, Lord, and we ask you to grant the graces they pray for. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember most specially our brother Benigno Simeon. And also, Lord, we remember all the souls commended to our prayers at this Mass. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Montserrat, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with the Apostles, with St. Ignatius of Loyola, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together, let us pray, Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too and grant them your guidance, most especially your leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, have a good day and let us again continue to pray during this month of July. So it's a new month. So let us pray for our spiritual journey this month. And then tomorrow also is First Friday. So again, have a good day. Thank you.
Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. Magpapatupad ang Caritas Pilipinas ng dalawang Alekapa programs simula ngayong last quarter ng taong 2021. Una ay scholarship assistance para sa ating mga kabataang academically low performers. Mga areas na identified natin mula sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Tutulungan po natin sila. 500 students ang ating budget na matutulungan. Pangalawa, feeding program. Meron pong mga identified areas na mataas ang percentages ng hunger. Tutulungan din po natin sila at ang estimated budget po natin ay para sa mga 6,000 na mga kabataan. Samahan niyo po kami. Tulungan niyo po ang Alekapa program ng Caritas Pilipinas. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko. Pagpalain po tayong lahat ng puong may kapal.